your way, little girl.
I mean, it was always like the goofy ones, like the Osmonds, wasn't it? The hipper girls always like David Cassidy.
It's a tricky situation. Hard to say just what the outcome.
I was one of David's women from probably about 1970, 71. That's when the Partridge Family started. And I would stay in every Friday night and worship.
How about you could give these ladies a kiss on the cheek each? Just a quick one on the cheek. As a representative of all you ladies, they get... Oh, no! Oh, dear, dear.
I was very different from that innocent boy next door American apple pie.
Fantastic.
Bring them all on. Come on.
Ladies and gentlemen, we've got to go now. He's quite happy underneath.
I had broken and had number one records in America for 2 years before it happened in Britain. And 1972 was a particularly definitive time. Someone defined it as the new fame. They said to me, you started the new fame. My trips to Britain were quite remarkable. It's just mass hysteria.
But he's just an ordinary mortal, isn't he?
Oh,
like
he's
me.
Not. He's not. He's an idol for everybody. Oh, he's beautiful.
And they called it puppy love. Just because we're in our team.
We used to have at school, there used to be groups of us then, that we'd have sort of the radio on at lunchtime to see who'd got to number one. There'd be the David Cassidy group and the Donny Osmond group.
Take away.
I don't really like that term, but I was. I was a teeny bopper. Puppy Love went up the charts, and we just kept going up and up and up and up. We went on tour. They started the intro, screaming like crazy, and I walked forward to the front of the stage, and I sing, and they called it Puppy Love. Screams like crazy. Someone help me! Help me! And I forgot the rest of the words. But nobody knew the difference, because there were so many screams.
So he was exactly the right age for us. He was a year or two older. He was a Mormon. He was practically wasn't even allowed to date girls until he was 16. He was like this fantasy boyfriend figure for us.
My maths teacher at the time wrote on my school report that Suzanne's preoccupation with a certain pop star has had a disastrous effect on her maths. I wanted to be like them. I mean, I thought they were just such a lovely family, and I just wanted to know if what they believed made them the people that they were.
God bless you.
Walking with a girlfriend up in London, we walked past what was the Mormon chapel, and I said, I'm sure that's the church the Osmonds go to, and we sort of plucked up courage and dared each other, shall we walk in? And we did.
Every time I hear a newborn baby cry.
They started teaching me and my friend more about the church. My parents weren't that impressed at the time because I was brought up as a Catholic. I was desperately in love with Donny. They thought I was at an impressionable age. I was baptised when I was 16.
I never got into the drug scene, thank goodness. I never slept around, thank goodness.
Although we had very similar kinds of images, I was really, you know, Jack the Lad and a bad boy, and he really was sweet and innocent.
Shall I come back again?
Donny was just a big old wussy pants.
Are you lonesome
tonight? He hadn't even hit puberty yet. What do you want to mess around with that for? You're already going to school with that ilk. David is already a man. Albeit a very slender-hipped, girly man.
If I didn't care.
My relationship with David when I was 10 consisted of kissing his poster, which was on a wall over my bed. It was a really sexy poster. He was kind of, had the lips slightly parted, his hooded eyes just kind of gazing out through his thick lashes.
In the 70s, it was sex, drugs, and rock and roll. I was not into drugs, but The other parts of that were something that I lived for, as most of us do.
I liked sex. Admittedly, completely two-dimensional, girly sex.
Didn't we have ourselves some kind of a summer?
I'd become this icon and this demigod and this wasn't who I was. It became so cumbersome being me, and it was a burden to carry that kind of fame.
Feeling that intensity, all that energy.
Sadly, on his farewell tour of Britain, the hysteria grew so intense at a concert at White City Stadium, a young girl lost her life.
She wasn't in the front. I don't think she was injured. She was on the sides. And I think just from the excitement of it all, she just had, a heart attack.
Whenever I'm away from you.
It was very difficult because I was not emotionally equipped for it. And I had to forget about my fame, forget about the past and rocking in the, you know. And I left it at the top. I walked away from it playing stadiums, being the most successful at that anybody had ever been. So what more did I have to prove?
People grew up. Their tastes and likes and dislikes changed. But in their mind, time froze for Donny Osmond. He was still the kid singing Puppy Love. It was very difficult to re-educate not just the public, but the industry that, hey, I've moved on to.
It's a bit like sort of a boyfriend you finished with. You don't really want any mention of them for years afterwards, but you still always think about them, particularly if it's your first love, which Donny was for me.
People never wanted to give him or myself, I think, any kind of creative credibility in that respect, you know, as they don't do now with teen acts. It's just a teen act.
I met David Cassidy the other week for the first time in my life, and I screamed. I have to say, I lost it. I lost all my composure.
In some ways, I just really would just like to say thank you to Donny and to his family for the happiness it's brought into my life by being a fan and where it's led me.
There was a boy.
For the child of the 70s, heaven was always just around the corner.